So a question here from Jonah, and Jonah asks, I'm using Gmail right now, but Google has locked me out of two accounts due to suspicious activity because there were multiple logins at the same time. All right, now this comment was on one of our videos about the dangers of using a Gmail account for business. And that's obviously a Gmail personal or consumer account rather than using a business account. And so if right now you are getting those kind of warnings from Google that there is suspicious activity happening in your account, and you're someone who's maybe sharing a Gmail account across multiple people and multiple users are using a Gmail account at the same time, then that is a pretty big red flag. That is a warning sign that if that continues, Google may actually choose to shut down or suspend your account. And that could be indefinitely. Unfortunately, we have seen many times that Google will actually restrict people's accounts, particularly if they're using a Gmail account for business purposes, and not switch them back on again. And we've had customers who've been locked out for weeks or months or even an indefinite period of time from their accounts. And so using a Gmail account for business is actually not a good idea. Now, I've got another video specifically on the dangers of using Gmail for business. That's on our channel. I won't re-go through all of those things. But what I will say is this. The key advantage of using Google Workspace instead of using a personal Gmail account is that it's actually a business account that you're paying money for, and therefore you get business support from Google. Now, not many people think about needing to get support for a Gmail account because it pretty much just works, right? It's not very often that something would go wrong in a Gmail account. It is an ecosystem and an application that has literally billions of users. And so Google wouldn't be able to get away with having bugs in there because, you know, people would be hassling them about it and they wouldn't be able to support that many users. But what Google does do is if you pay for a business account is you actually get access to business support. And because you own the domain name associated with a Google Workspace account, which is probably yourbusinessname.com, well, you always are able to access the back end of your Google Workspace account using that domain name. So what are the scenarios where you may lose access to a Workspace account and need to get back in with your domain name? Well, maybe if you've forgotten the administrator password to your account, that's a pretty common one. I know it sounds silly, but it does happen from time to time where someone gets locked out of the admin account. And what that typically looks like is maybe someone else in your company set up the account for you. They were an admin assistant, or they were a marketing manager, or maybe a web developer who set it up years and years and years ago. And you, as the business owner, were just given an email account, but you were never given the administration rights. And what can happen is that person leaves the business, and then eventually you end up in a situation where you need to access the admin account, but you don't know the name or you don't know the password for that admin account, and you run into some kind of issue with your individual account as the business owner, and all of a sudden you're locked out. Well, what you can do is you can use your domain name to make some DNS setting changes and actually get back into the administrator account of your Google Workspace account, and there is a method to do that using account recovery from Google. Okay, scenario number one. Next one, scenario number two, is that you have someone within the business that takes some kind of malicious action. Now, it's not the kind of thing that is nice to think about, that a staff member may lock you out of your accounts, but unfortunately, it does happen from time to time. The most common occurrence of this in small businesses is you have two business owners who also happen to be married or in a relationship of some sort, and their relationship is breaking down and their business has to go through a divorce at the same time, and someone decides to start screwing with the other person. Not literally. And so what happens is we've had many business owners come to us and say, hey, I've been locked out of my Google account by my spouse, and I can't get any of my work done. I can't look after my customers. We're going through a nasty breakup. I just need to get access to my account again so I can get things working. And so what we do in that case, again, is we use the domain name to recover and get back into the Google account. And then from that Google account, we can then reactivate the administrator account or reactivate the business owner who has been suspended. Number three is something goes wrong and there is a violation of a policy and Google actually switches off or suspends your account. So that may be someone sending too many emails from their mailbox. From time to time, you can get flagged by Google's spamming policy and they will actually just shut down or switch off an account. If there's some kind of, you know, exploitation or inappropriate type material accidentally uploaded to somebody's drive. You know, who knows what staff get up to on their personal computers from time to time. They can accidentally upload the wrong thing into something like Google Drive, and automatically it can be flagged and then your account can be shut down. Also, you may have a computer that is infected with some kind of virus or malware, and it's using your Gmail account to actually spam other people. For a number of different reasons, you may end up in a situation where your Workspace account is actually switched off or suspended. And the only way to get that unsuspended or switched back on again is to actually go through a DNS retrieval to get access to your account and then get access to support. And then you can plead with support to have your account switched back on. Now, one of the advantages of working with a reseller partner, which itGenius is that you can actually have us log into the back end of your account without actually needing to know your administrator password. So as a reseller, we have a reseller console, and that means that we can access the back end of all of our customers' accounts without our customer needing to give us their username and password. And it doesn't even need to cost an additional license. You don't have to give us like an extra admin account called itGenius or anything like that. We've just got a console where we can see into the back end, a little bit like Google support, and that means we can get back into your account. And that's one of the key advantages of working with a reseller like us. Even if you're not interested in joining up for our Concierge program, which is premium support for Google Workspace, even if you just want to run your billing through us and run it through our console, you don't pay any extra, but you get the benefit that if something does go wrong with your account, you always have that back door where we can get back into your account and get it up and running much faster than you trying to go through Google support yourself individually. Then that's an advantage to start working with us at itGenius. So if you're interested in that, you can click the link down below this video. Our offer is called the Transfer In Offer, and the Transfer In Offer gets you access to Genius Academy, which is a professional set of videos that train you and your team on the best practice of you using Google Workspace. You also get access to our support service for any emergencies, and you get a couple of other free goodies from our team. And of course, if there's any discounts for things like Google Workspace or other tools, you get priority access to that, which some discounts are not available to the public, but us as a reseller, we can help you out. So if you're interested in that, there's no cost to that program at all. It's called Transfer In. Click on the link down below this video and you can jump onto that. If you like this content, please hit subscribe and hit the bell notification so you can be notified when we go live or drop new content on the channel. If you'd like to connect with us, hit us up on social media or join our free community group. All the links to that are right below this video. If you'd like to learn more about Google Workspace and the technology ecosystem, you can join our free Genius Academy by transferring your billing across to itGenius, or you can join a Workspace Basics Bootcamp. Now, if you're a business owner and you're interested in an audit on your technology stack or your Workspace account, or you're looking to do a project in the tech world, well, you can take advantage of our free consultation. And if you need help right now, then consider joining Concierge or taking up a quick fix with our team for professional support for your tech stack.